Les Brown, the greatest motivational speaker who won the Golden Gavel Award in Toastmasters International, said, "Don't believe in others' opinion of you as your reality." I found a fantastic example in a small historical event that connected a young boy and a horse. That young boy and horse would never have got connected if that boy believed in others' opinion of his abilities and accepted that the horse was worthless, vile, and useless. The young boy I'm talking about is not an ordinary boy. He went on to become the greatest cavalry general history has ever seen and won half of the known world during his time. I'm talking about Alexander the Great. It was an event in 344 BC that connected this young boy with his horse. And that connection lasted long, really long. 18 long years, more than 12,000 miles. From 344 BC to 326 BC, and from Macedonia to River Hydaspes banks in ancient India. Come with me, Toastmasters and friends. Let's go to 344 BC to witness this historical event live. Let it unfold in front of us. Judges, don't forget to come with me. Now we are standing there in front of a big ground behind the barricade with a lot of Macedonians to accompany us. We are seeing the spectacle unfold in front of us. In front of us, there is a large gallery where King Philip II is seated with his ministers. With him is seated the most important of his many wives, Queen Olympias. One look at her, you know why she is the most important. She is glowing and dazzling like Angelina Jolie in Alexander the Great. Seated next to Olympias is Alexander, all of 13 years age, still not great. He is keenly watching the events happening in the ground, just like general evaluator in a Toastmaster meeting. Maybe his teacher Aristotle will call him for a report at the end of the proceedings. We see horses being paraded as King Philip is today recruiting horses for his cavalry, for his next conquest. His cavalrymen are going, selecting the horses, haggling the prices, taking them for a test ride, coming back, taking the approval of King Philip, recruiting them into the cavalry. Things went wrong, and suddenly a stallion appears on the scene. The whole crowd is stunned seeing this horse. It looks gigantic, big, black, with a very strong body, strong legs. It's glowing in the afternoon sun. It's black, matte finish. It was like iPhone 10 revealed it. This was brought by Philonicus from Thessalia to be offered to the king for his inspection. King Philip was impressed. He is asking, "What is the price of this horse?" He says, "King Philip, you must buy this horse. It will give you great mileage and will take you for long distance. It has great horsepower." King Philip still asks him, "What is the price?" The price that was quoted stuns even the king. 13 talents, he says. A talent is a measure used in those days. One talent is equal to 26 kilos of a precious metal. And precious metal in those days was gold. It means The horse was prized at 350 kilograms of gold. Enormous even for a king. King says, what is so good about it? So he sends his assistants to test it. As they go near the horse turns wild. It's not allowing anybody to mount it and take a test ride. Finally, the king's own ego is affected now. I am the conqueror of many countries. What is this small beast? He walks to the horse. Even he cannot tame it. The horse nods and jumps, tries to kick him away. King Philip moves away from the horse and says, this beast is mad. It's worthless for us. Take it away. Alexander is watching all this from the gallery. He is saying, we must be foolish to lose this wonderful animal. For it will serve us for many, many years. King says, not at all. It's a wild animal. Send it away. Alexander fervently requests his dad, can I go and have a test ride? Philip really gets wild now. He says, all experienced warriors have tried and failed. What are you? You think you are better than them? The whole crowd laughs. But Alexander says, I want to try it. So what do you do if you fail, Alexander? He says, I will pay for it. How? Beg, borrow, or mint? Alexander still nonchalantly goes near the horse. He has been observing the horse since morning. It is afraid of its own shadow. He gently goes near the horse, pats it, and then, Bucephalus, that's what I'm going to call you, can you turn around and face the sun? How beautiful it is. The horse turns. Slowly he walks the horse forward. Then the horse starts slowly running. With that, Alexander also runs. And before anybody realizes, he just jumps onto the horse and starts to ride the horse towards the sun. The crowd that was ridiculing him now starts to cheer. Everybody is cheering. And Alexander just allows the horse to run far away towards the sun. And then when he feels the horse is now completely calm and ready to take his command, he controls the horse, turns the horse around, back to the ground where we are all watching him with cheers. The crowd is cheering, we have found a great man. A young boy who mounted the horse is coming back with sprouts of greatness already showed. And this journey with the horse and Alexander continued forever. In many wars, they fought together and won. When you remember this story, remember that Alexander was ridiculed when he went to tame that horse. He was told, you don't have the ability. You fail in front of everybody else. But he didn't accept. He didn't accept that animal was worthless. And finally, he got a great horse that won him many awards until his last war with the horse. Over to you.